PCR is a powerful technique that allows us to make billions of copies of specific pieces of DNA. The first step in PCR is to open up the two strands of DNA to expose the genetic information encoded by the nitrogen bases, A, C, T, and G. In the next step, custom-made DNA molecules help us find the beginning and end of the DNA piece of interest among the billions of letters in the genome. These genetic bookmarks are called primers. The third and final step is to fill in the genetic information between the primers. An enzyme called DNA polymerase adds the building blocks of DNA called nucleotides to create an identical DNA strand. DNA polymerase works in our own cells to replicate our own DNA each time a cell divides. The first step in PCR is known as denaturation and is enabled by high heat. The second step is called annealing, and different primers have different and very specific annealing temperatures, typically between 50 and 60 degrees Celsius. The third step is called extension. DNA polymerase used in PCR works best at 72 degrees Celsius. In these three steps, we've taken our original DNA molecule and obtained an identical copy of a very specific fragment. If we repeat these three steps one more time, we'll go from two copies to four. Repeat it again and we'll obtain eight copies. And again, and we'll get 16, and 32, and 64, 128, well, you get the idea. DNA amplification by PCR is an exponential process. After 30 copy cycles, we will have 2 to the 30, or 1 billion identical DNA copies. This is enough DNA, for example, to detect a pathogen in blood such as HIV or Ebola, or to amplify trace amounts of DNA found at a crime scene, or to enable any of the other powerful applications of PCR.